glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. At BYU, the legacy of great quarterbacks is rich, deep, and extensive. The Cougars hoping to get great play on both sides of the ball today and score a huge victory in Provo. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Site for this college football matchup. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Clemson tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Here's a running play. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
Pushed out of bounds at the 40. From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Caught out in the open. Tackle right around the 50.
Wide receiver's role in a play-action pass is to get into position and to hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at. But make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target to the quarterback.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 48.
Four down. 87's getting the ball.
He gets rid of this one. Chucks it downfield. Almost intercepted.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
McDaniel to punt. And he's tackled at the 23-yard line. Well, here comes the guy that we've all been waiting for. Our player to watch this game. Clark's vision, his patience, Kirk behind center, really makes him a complete player.
And Brad, both of those attributes are especially important anytime you're out on the road and you're playing in a hostile environment. This kid is really cool under pressure, and no matter how loud this crowd's going to get today, I don't think he's going to have much of a problem with blocking them out and playing his game.
Guys, I really like what the offensive coordinator's doing here. Throwing it on first and second down will keep the defense guessing.
Let's go, D.
looked like the same play they just called.
Yeah, it was. The defense was ready for it this time.
Second and 10. Ball on 34. He might not be able to get the pass off. Slings it out there incomplete.
Remember, this is college football. All you need is 1 foot down to be able to make this catch. This time, the wide receiver is just too close to the boundary, not allowing himself to get either his left or right foot down.
And they make the stop at the 46.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them. That makes it first and 10.
And he's taken down around the 38-yard line. He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. Zips it to the back. He's taken down right around the 34. And down he goes at the 39. The defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
From the 39-yard line. Second down. Gets it. He's in space. Brought down around the 19-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
He gets out to about the 11-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Tackled at the 4-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
They're lucky he was able to hang on to the football. He took a pretty good shot.
It's the tailback. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 12-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 7-0. Clemson's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. From their own 28-yard line. Second down.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Larry. He's on the run. They bring him down.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Made at about the 47-yard line. So at the end of one, Clemson leads it 7-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Yardage on that run. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They'll bring him down at the 36.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over to the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
And he's knocked out immediately after the catch. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. They go right, and he's tackled behind the line.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That brings up second and 13.
So it's second and 13. Ball on the 29-yard line.
Mike 51.
He's going to try and scramble. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
That'll make it 39.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back. And they make the stop right around the 16-yard line. Wow, a long game, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down. So the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Here's an update from the studio and restatement.
The Ponies ready to tee it up as SMU is set to go in University Park. And for UTEP, they're looking to win their third straight. The Miners are on top, 10-7.
7-3 in this one. McDaniel has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Williams from the 6. And he's taken down at the 37. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Clemson is up 4. He's on the run. Gets out to around the 48.
That's a gain of 15. First down.
He's wrapped up for the sack.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. And he's taken down
right around the 38-yard line.
That's a junior 17.
Tight right.
That makes it first and 10.
Mike's 50. Red 2.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's leveled
at the 31.
That reception good for 7 yards.
This is good timing here between the quarterback and the wide receiver. Recognizing the soft coverage from the defensive back, the quarterback puts the ball right in the money for a nice game.
Makes the first down catch. He's tackled
around the 23-yard line.
Good hook up there. They get an 8-yard gain and a first down.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first.
That makes it second and 14.
We've got a second and 14. Ball on the 27. Clemson is up by 4.
Easy.
Quick throw. They'll drop him for a loss. 2-yard loss.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
This is the 9th play of this drive. Looking for 6. That'll bring up 4th and long, and we should be seeing the kicker here.
Good stand by the defense to keep them out of the end zone on this drive.
Looks like they're going to go for it on 4th down. He's got it with room to run. Big play, and it's 1st and goal.
Brooks makes the tackle at the 5-yard line.
Kill.
Makes it 1st and goal.
Check! Dancer!
Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown! A nice play as the offense gets it through the air.
Yeah, they've had some success in their short passing game, so they felt confident they could make that play work down inside the 10.
Tacks on the extra point. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The Ponies ready to tee it up as SMU is set to go in University Park. Let's take yet another peek at this game. And for SMU, they could drop their 4th in a row. UTEP out front, 17-14.
14-3 game here, Reese. Brady has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 23. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's scrambling. Got the corner. He's taken down at the 36-yard line.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
From their own 36-yard line, it's 1st down. He's out of bounds
at about the 45.
One thing about this quarterback is when the play breaks down, he has a way of improvising and getting positive yards.
from the 48-yard line. First down. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
Now he tries to buy some time. They bring the quarterback down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He airs it out. That's a great tackle at the four. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. 14-3, Clemson.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Neither ground game very productive in that first half, David, and I really think it came down to each player on the defensive side executing their assignments and trying to get the positive self-determination that they wanted from a defense.
No doubt about it. And you look at the defense is doing such a great job stopping the run. That's the first thing that you do 99% of the time in meetings is, what are we going to do first? Stop the run. Because that's usually the place where you can get gashed the most. It's the simplest. Quarterbacks don't have to go back and make reads. It's designed. You know what they're going to do. But it also comes down to the big boys up front and those big boys making holes. And right now, I don't see many holes. And I don't care if you have Barry Sanders. I don't care if you have the best running back of all time, whoever it is in your backfield. If there's not a hole, there's no yards to be made. There's nothing they can do. So the defensive line doing a great job stuffing the run.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 26-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he's tackled right away. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Looking for his man, incomplete.
Can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 40. Fires it out. And down he goes at the 47-yard line.
Jacobson brings him down at the 47-yard line. That makes it third and 3.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Watch 19, watch 19.
Brought down around the 41-yard line.
The 41-yard line. That makes it second and 2.
They'll get him for a loss. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper. A loss of one. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Here he goes. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. And he is drilled. 13. Touchdown. That was a well drawn up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he hits the PAT. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
Off to University Park we go. This one's been entertaining us all day long. The Mustangs hammer that running game and score a touchdown. And for Johnson, he's caught one for a touchdown. The Mustangs are on top, 27-24, closing in on halftime.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. Clemson, to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
Tackle made at the 33.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Four down. 51, Mike 51.
Three down.
And he hits him hard at the 30-yard line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Man, watch out here. They'll bring him down around the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on their own 37. Wants to go long and does. Keeps a foot in and pulls it down. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful at their passing game. That time the quarterback threw it to a spot and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. He scrambled. Decides to slide. So with that run, they pick up another first.
It's a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Falling back, complete. Tackle around the 10-yard line.
That'll make it 77.
From the 10-yard line, second down. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Caught. Touchdown. And they're not ready to quit just yet. Makes the PAT. A quick update now. Here's Reese.
The Ponies ready to tee it up as SMU is set to go in University Park. We've been watching this thing all day long. And for UTEP,
They are relentless, just hammering away with that running game in the big offensive line and score a touchdown. The Miners are on top, 31-27.
All right, Reese, back to our game. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20, heading for the corner. Across midfield, inside the 30, to the 10. Touchdown, Tigers. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Brady is lined up to kick this one off. Washington fields it at the 2. Oh, he got nailed on that one.
Boy, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out on the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Play action here. He's going to scramble. And they make the stop right around the 30.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Three down.
Hey, Mike 51.
They go.
648.
They hook up over the middle, and he's taken down at the 40. The grab and steps out right away. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, the Tigers lead 28-10. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. On the run, runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled at the 27-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's the third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Now he's scrambling. Johnson comes away with 5 yards on the scramble there. Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 22-yard line. And a quick throw. He goes out of bounds at the 21. Just a yard there.
The defense respects this guy and knows they have to pay a lot of attention to him. He didn't have any room after that catch.
This is the 8th play of this drive. He's going to come up short. Good tackle. The fullback rumbles ahead for about a yard.
That'll make it 4th and 2.
So they're going to go for it here.
Try right.
Four down. 51, Mike. Mike, 51.
Go.
Go.
Hands off left, and they got him behind the line. And that was a big stop defensively.
Yeah, they only needed a few yards here to keep the drive alive. Great job by the defense to shut him down.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He has some room. Makes it to the 31. Hit before he could go anywhere.
Gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
Right, right, right. Three
down, three down.
Mike 50, Mike 50.
Dog four. Red seven, red seven.
They just didn't get the snap off in time. Here's the call.
Delay of game, offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So they have a second and five following the penalty. Gets out to about the 44-yard line.
First down.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Red two, orange three.
Give to the tailback. He fights forward to about the 46. The running back gets two on the carry.
And he's brought down there by the senior at linebacker. That won't be the last time today we'll be talking about this young man.
Second and eight. Ball on their own 46.
Dog four. Green eight. Got it.
Run.
Nice run there. Palmer comes away with 5 yards on the carry.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. Third down.
They go with a run. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 43.
Mike's 50, Mike's 50. Red 2, green 15. Go!
He fights forward to about the 43. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
They're lucky he was able to hang on to the football. He took a pretty good shot.
Here's the eighth play of the series. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. 28-10, Tigers. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.